artist and a practitioner. Ani, the relationship Marco Siamio Nepali Paubha painting ma goes back to the 70s. So as I say, both Nepali ra English ko antarkriya karyakram gane, because rather than a talk, Robert would like to do an interactive program. Ani wale aafno relationship with the Paubha painters ko bare ma kura garnu huncha from the 1970s, where there were very few foreigners coming into Nepal and really working closely with the artists. Tapai yo audience lai ta maile bhanna pardaina, tara Nepal only opened to the outside world in 1951. Samanta Nepal was closed to all foreigners. Ani Prajatantra Divas 2007 pasi foreigners came. And Nepal was a beautiful medieval kingdom, untouched by what India saw, which is Muslim invasion and also colonial rule. So hamro chai tyo dui ta nabhayo, it was a very pure artistic tradition that traveled, but also there was a decline in the arts. So hamro chai, we will look at what was the instigation of in the 1930s and 40s with the artist Sipi Muni's father,
thank you all for coming. It's an honor to be here at Samundra's wonderful exhibition. Overwhelmingly beautiful, and many, many thanks to the Bun Manzakya as well, his wife Anjana, and Siddhartha for putting on the show for me and for hosting this whole event. Special thanks for Dina for coming from Doha to supervise the events, to put up the whole exhibition, and also to write the catalogue, not only for this exhibition, but for the previous exhibition known as Jewels of Newar Art. So Dina and I have only met a few times, and I hope we can meet a lot more in the future and do some work together to help with the whole Newar Art. Does anybody not understand what I've just said? Put the hands up. You can't hear. Well, why don't you come closer?
It's very hard to hear.
It's very hard to hear.
Well, I'm painting Robert Yerjiko, your class of Amgorsu. Using Marco 1978 Tira, Wale Bonon Baku, Wako, Vere Gorsu, practice for book cover. अब परम्परागत पौवामा र थाङ्का पेन्सिलमा चाहिँ हाम्रो यो जुन देवी देवताको पुरा मूर्तिको रूप देखाइन्छ र उहाँको चाहिँ खालि हात मात्रै भएकोले चाहिँ एकदमै त्यसको यो कन्ट्रोभर्सी आयो. त्यो जुन बुक लेख्ने मान्छेहरू पनि किन यसको बनाएको यसको नहुनुपर्ने भनेर एउटा जुन एउटा मौलिकता जुन उहाँले प्रस्तुति गर्नुभयो त्यसलाई एकदमै कन्ट्रोभर्सी थियो. सो उहाँको वर्कलाई चाहिँ पहिला एकदम मान्छेहरूले एक किसिमको नमन पराउने जस्तो पनि सिचुएसन आयो. आर्टमा होइन कि त्यसको रूपान्तरण कसरी, किन भन्दा थाङ्का पेन्टिङको भन्दा एकदमै फरक भएको.
I got some more illustration cards that I made. I'll pass these around in the circle, so if they go down and they don't come back, it's okay. If somebody gets to steal one, I'm not going to chase you down. But I'm going tomorrow morning. Before that, I was doing also doing my own Eastern style.
Nepalको सबभन्दा
to draw the systems of measurements used to draw different classes of deities. And there are various classes of deities. There are the Buddhas, which are very tall figures, and they're measured in feet. So the Buddhas, there are two systems of measure. One is 125 big Buddhas, and one is 120.
How many
artists here know these systems of measure?
No,
you really know the systems of measure?
Foundation plan, like just good.
Like you, if you want to grow roses, it's a very good idea to first of all erect a trellis so that the roses can grow up. They can grow up and blossom and get the sunlight. Otherwise they will just grow around the ground, spread around the ground. So I think as regards talking about traditional Newar Art, I think it would be very, very good if there was a school established where to begin with we learned about the systems of measurements of the deities. And this will give a good idea of human proportion and divine proportion. Leonardo's famous Vitruvian man, where there's a man standing in a circle like this and his legs are together on the path, is exactly based on these canons of measurement. So these canons of measurement go back to the Greek and Roman times. And then they were brought into India and matched with Indian Shastras, which also had the same systems of divine measurement. So this is a kind of universal system that is all to do with the drawing of divine figures.
The system of proportion.
I also learned how to make my own brushes from hair from a wild cat, which was available in Paubha. And also, that time. Because Tibetan artists would also have to make their own brushes. and also how to use mineral pigments, grinding mineral pigments. A lot of the artists in the Kathmandu Valley say they use stone colour. I don't believe it, personally, maybe a few do. In general, it's poster paint they use, or they sometimes buy the pigments from the market and mix them with white, basically a white base. There, in Rajasthan in India, there is one man called Shamibana, who is the last person who knows how to make all of the Indian pigments that we use in miniature painting. I have samples of all of these pigments. For example, the four grades of pure lapis lazuli. When you grind lapis, the more you grind it, the lighter it becomes. So a lot of people say that they use lapis lazuli in paintings. But very hardly anybody in the world, just this one person now, knows how to separate the particles of lapis to get very deep blue particles. This man should come to Kathmandu. We should establish some kind of institute where people could really learn right from the beginning these techniques. And also, while I'm talking on this, I feel that the whole tradition of Newar Art, held by the Bhadracharyas, is also almost lost. You know, there are how many Bhadracharyas who carry the knowledge of the Newar pantheon deities are left. And those who do tend to want to keep it secret and not pass it on. And because of that, they have different views. They will say, one person will say, oh, it's like this, and another person will say, it's like that. So we need, I'm not saying we, I'm saying you, essentially. I think we need to kind of work together and use intelligence to kind of help develop your own tradition, bring it back to life. If you're going to talk about traditional art, if you're not going to talk about traditional art, you can do what you love, which is what I did later on, after having learned all these things. So you can work within the tradition. And Samundra, you know, Udai, people are saying, it's no longer belonging to the tradition, it's used now, plan like this and this. Actually, it's a whole new vision. Art should be free on this level. The same is happening in Tibetan art. A lot of the young Tibetan artists who learned on painting now do conceptual painting, and it's very popular in the West. That may be a bit strong, what I was just saying, but I think I need to say that. One more little point. While I was in Nepal, 73 to 74, I became very influenced by Sidi Mooney's paintings. I met Sidi Mooney, went to his house a few times. And this painting I made in 1976, kind of in memory of what I saw Sidi Mooney around the outside. So it's my first painting in the Newar style, maybe my only painting in the Newar style. So I will pass this image around. I think this is very, very important because I feel that there is a lot missing in the understanding of what the possibilities and potential.
Yeah,
segment ma chhiwale ke garnu ke bhanu bhas bhane aba euta chai technique ko hisabe hami newar thanka newar painting ra thanka tibetan thanka sarma chai to euta antar ra farak ke paunchha bhane thanka painting ma chai ekdamai systematic hisabe euta training ko rupma kasari rang banaune dekhi lera kasari tyo goal halne dekhi lera ekdam systematic rupma chalira chha तर उहाँ 1970समा यहाँ आउँदाखेरि चाहिँ उहाँले के देख्नुभयो भने मास्टर्सहरू हुनुहुन्थ्यो यहाँ सानो सानो पकेजमा एक दुईजना एकदमै ब्रिलियन्ट मास्टर्स र उहाँले चाहिँ जस्तो कि सुन कसरी लगाउने अब चार आठ सुनबाट उहाँले चाहिँ त्यो मास्टर आर्टिस्टले चाहिँ त्यसलाई अब धुलोको रूपमा परिणत गरेर अनि त्यो चाहिँ पेन्टिङमा अप्लाई गर्ने त्यस्तो टेक्निक पनि 1970समा पनि थियो र अहिले पनि छ र बिस्तारै यो हुँदै गएको छ र जसरी टिबेटन ट्रेडिसनले चाहिँ एउटा आफ्नो परम्परालाई चाहिँ नबिर्साइकन र एकदमै बाहिरको मान्छेलाई पनि ट्रेनिङ दिइकन अब त्यो ट्रेडिसन चल्दैछ त्यस्तै गरिकन अहिलेको भएको जुन आर्टिस्टहरू हुन्छ र अहिलेको ट्रेडिसन मास्टर्स हुनुहुन्छ उहाँलाई चाहिँ त्यो ज्ञान चाहिँ अहिले हामीले क्याप्चर गर्न सक्यौँ भने त्यो पछि गएर सबै लोप भएर जान्छ तर गुड न्युज के छ भने उहाँले देख्नुहुन्छ कि 1970समा जति किसिमको पौवा आर्टिस्टहरू आयो अहिले त झनै त्यसको बढ्दैछ तर त्यो फाउन्डेसन बिना बढेको मात्रै छ नि राम्रो होइन त्यसमा चाहिँ आफ्नो मौलिकता आफ्नो टेक्निकहरू कस्तो छ त्यो चाहिँ जानकारी गर्नुपर्छ अर्को कुरा तपाईँहरूलाई थाहा छ होला हरेक सिम्बलको चाहिँ तिनवटा लेयर अफ मिनिङ हुन्छ क्या एउटा चाहिँ बाह्य भयो है एउटा चाहिँ भित्री भित्री किसिमको अनि एउटा चाहिँ गुह्य जुन चाहिँ दीक्षा दिएको मान्छेहरूलाई मात्रै हुन्छ अनि त्यो तिन अन्तर एउटै चिजको चाहिँ तिनवटा मिनिङ हुन्छ सो टेक्निक मात्रै थाहा गर्नु जरुरत छ है एकमा तर सेकेन्डमा चाहिँ यो के बनाइरहेको यसको सिम्बोलिजम पनि त्यसको सिम्बल र तिनटै किसिमको एउटा अर्थ त्यसको दार्शनिक हिसाबले के भन्दै गएको हो त्यो पनि जान्न चाहिँ एकदम जरुरत छ सो उहाँले भन्नुभयो म पहिला आएको भएर चाहिँ मैले त्यो सबै बिस्तारै धेरैचोटि प्र्याक्टिस गर्दा त्यो पनि सिकेँ यो थ्री लेभल्स इनर आउटर सिकेको छ हामीले त्यो चिज चाहिँ हामीले गर्यौँ
Having said that, I love the work under Samundra, with Dina and Shrestha, and all the whole spectrum of Newar artists, because I see the art as incredibly inspiring, spiritually inspiring, and very devotional. And although it's very little known in the West, when people come to my house, they are knocked out by what they see. People always say, oh, I could look at this for hours. The average time the person can look at an image is about 45 seconds. And it's very short. People have very short attention spans. But the image remains. They are impressed by what they see in the art. So, although it's so little known in the West, now you are starting to get Chinese people, collectors, Chinese curators, even, I would say, rather than collectors, I would make a distinction between those who exhibit for cultural sake, those who collect for potential profit. I think it's starting to spread into China, and I think maybe in China it will have a very strong influence on what was the communist tradition. People will turn to Buddhism, turn to exploring other forms of awareness, philosophical systems. The present system they have is obviously inadequate, which is based on finance. So I see the potential for this art spreading greatly because it really is exquisitely beautiful and you are so gifted already. It just would be very useful if there was a bit more training, a systematic training, and the Rajacharyas who hold the knowledge would be able to transmit it before it's lost.
उहाँले चाहिँ अब 1970सदेखि अहिलेसम्मको उहाँको एक्सपिरियन्समा चाहिँ यति हाई लेभलको हाई स्किलको वा आर्टिस्टहरू देख्नुहुन्छ त्यो देख्दाखेरि चाहिँ उहाँलाई एकदमै खुसी लाग्छ र यति यस्तो इन्सपिरेसनल वर्कहरू हाम्रो नेवार आर्टिस्टहरूले जसमाले नामिन भएको हाम्रो सिद्धिमुनिदेखि लिएर उदय चन्द्र हाम्रो समन्द्रमाझी राज प्रकाश लोकराय हुनुहुन्छ दिज आर अहिलेको कन्टेम्पोरेरी पौवा पेन्टर्सहरूले चाहिँ त्यतिको किसिमको इन्सपायर्ड वर्क चाहिँ बनाउन सक्नुहुन्छ तर पनि त्यसमा अलिकति इन्ट्रेस्टिङ कुरा के छ भने बाहिरको मान्छेले अझैसम्म टिबेटन आर्ट जति चिनारी थाल्छ अहिलेसम्म हाम्रो चाहिँ नेवार पौवाको त्यति चिनारी भएकै छैन अब बिस्तारै हुन्छ जस्तो कि उहाँले चाइनिज कलेक्टर्स अब उहाँ हाम्रो चाओ हुनुहुन्छ यहाँ र अरू कलेक्टर्सहरू इन्टरनेसनली पनि आउँदै गर्नुहुन्छ तर अहिलेको इन्ट्रेस्टिङ एस्पेक्ट उहाँको चाहिँ चाइनाको रोल चाहिँ इन्ट्रेस्टिङ होला भन्नुहुन्छ फाइनेन्सियल हिसाबमा पनि तर अल्सो पौवा पेन्टिङ पौवा चित्रको चाहिँ खास निचोड चाहिँ के भन्दाखेरि धार्मिक हिसाबले गर्दा बौद्ध धर्मको र बुद्धिस्ट फिलोसफीको प्रचार गर्नलाई पनि एउटा यस्तो सुन्दर माध्यमबाट गर्न सकिन्छ जसले कि चाइनिजहरूले त्यसप्रति आफै आफू त्यो एट्र्याक्सन भइरहेको छ सो आर्टको माध्यमबाट एउटा ह्युमन ट्रान्सफर्मेसनकै लागि चाहिँ एकदमै पावरफुल मिडियम हुन जान्छ जसमा चाहिँ नेपाली पौवा आर्टिस्टहरूले चाहिँ एकदमै ठुलो भूमिका खेल्न सक्छ
I was quite a bit draftsman in my time. I stopped drawing. I can't use my hand anymore. My eyes are a bit. My hand is ruined mainly from writing with a pen. I've written hundreds and hundreds of letters replying to people asking me questions. I was good in my time, but these artists of today are far better than I ever was. And, you know, I exult in their abilities, in their humility. I find incredible humility amongst the artists. I love them very much. And the thing that binds me to them is love, essentially. An expert is somebody who started before you. I've been an expert possibly in art, in Oriental art, or India, or Tibet. Maybe because I started before most of you here, in fact. When I was doing that research, most of you probably wouldn't even born. So, you know, I think it's you have so much potential. I feel that you need to be free. The artists need to be free from shackles, from being caught in a system where they have to keep producing all of the time, getting very low prices, and while they're eventually sold at very, very high prices by middlemen and dealers. It's not something that's really got much to do with art at all. It's got much more to do with self-image and greed rather than a promotion of the art. So, the art needs to be nourished. The artists need to be nourished. They need these opportunities. We need some kind of... There's a local teacher over here who's teaching Ajayi. I don't know who else is teaching at the time. But, you know, it's possible that you can, amongst yourselves, you can form a guild in Lhasa, as in the medieval times in Renaissance Europe, they had guilds, artist guilds. The artists would gather together, and they would make decisions on how the things should work, and who was going to commission what, and how it should be done. You need to be autonomous. You need to be free, autonomous. Art is militant, naked, and unashamed, and that's how it should be.
यस्तो राम्रो भन्नुभयो कि अब ट्रान्सलेट गर्ने काम उहाँको अब यति
Oh, that's enough. Now I think we should take some questions.
Questions?
That's not something I can answer. You need to ask somebody else. I'm the worst person to answer that question.
I can attempt to answer them. A question say, I'm your Bodhisattva tradition, so say, Halipati K,
should I go to the English? It's okay. I think you tell me afterwards.
Buddhism. Tibetan was, Japanese Buddhism was, Chinese Buddhism was. And kina bhandakheri chai tyo jun chai Newar Bodha parampara, Newar Buddhist tradition chai India ko Sanskrit Buddhism ma base bhayeko. So aba junai pani hami Buddhism ko base samjhau ke chai Pali bhasha ma ra Sanskrit bhasha ma huncha. So Nepal ma matrai yo Nepal bhanda pani ajhai Kathmandu upatyaka ma matrai त्यो बौद्ध परम्परा चाहिँ कहिलेसम्म चलिरहेको छ जहाँ चाहिँ इन्डियामा लोक भएको भएर गइसक्यो टिबेटमा नेपालबाट गयो र चाइनामा पनि अनि जापानमा पनि सो रिचुअलको हिसाबले हेर्दा जुन चाहिँ हाम्रो यो विधिको हिसाबले हेर्दाखेरि चाहिँ वज्रचार्य कृष्णमा भएको त्यो विधिको एउटा ज्ञान चाहिँ अरू कुनै ट्रेडिसनमा छैन जस्तो होम कसरी गर्नु वी ओन्ली सी इट इन एट्थ टेन्थ सेन्चुरी टेक्स्ट होइन किताबमा लेखेको छ र हाम्रो वज्रचार्य गुरुहरूले चाहिँ कसरी त्यसलाई चाहिँ प्रस्तुति गर्ने भनेर अनब्रोकन ट्रेडिसन सो सेकेन्ड इम्पोर्टेन्ट पोइन्ट चाहिँ किन भन्दाखेरि तान्त्रिक ट्रेडिसन भएर तान्त्रिक बुद्धिज्म तन्त्रमा बेस भएको चाहिँ गुरु शिष्य परम्परा अनुसारमा हुन्छ गुरुले चाहिँ दीक्षा दिएर कसरी त्यो एउटा एकदम सिस्टमेटिक ढङ्गमा आएकोले चाहिँ यहाँको नेवार पनि बुद्धिस्ट ट्रेडिसन र जापानको सिङ्गन ट्रेडिसन उहाँ तोक्ताईको भेरी फेमिलियर त्यसमा केही फरक छ सो जापानिज बुद्धिस्ट सिङ्गन ट्रेडिसन एन्ड नेवार बुद्धिस्टमा प्र्याक्टिसमा छैन बट मेरो ओन एक्सपिरियन्स चाहिँ के भने एकदम हाम्रो चाहिँ संकुचित भएकोले चाहिँ कसैलाई यो भन्न हुँदैन यो देखाउन हुँदैन भन्ने चाहिँ एकदमै गाह्रो छ मलाई चक्र सङ्ग्रहको बारेमा मैले रिसर्च गर्दाखेरि विच इज अहिले हाम्रो प्रिय देवता भन्छ कति गुरुहरूले भन्नुभयो चक्र सङ्ग्रहको नाम मात्रै लियो भने पनि पाप लाग्छ तर अब सबै चक्र सङ्ग्रहको बेस्ट वर्क्सहरू बाहिर गइसकेको छ अब कसरी त मेरो क्वेसन तपाईँलाई होइन गुह्य देउता जब आगममा हुनुपर्ने देउता दुईजना मान्छेमा आँखाभन्दा देख्न हुँदैन भन्ने देउता चाहिँ कसरी लस एन्जलस काउन्टी म्युजियममा पुग्यो कसरी ब्रिटिस म्युजियममा पुग्यो त बाहिरको मान्छेले त चोरेर त लग्या होइन त सो कसरी बेचियो त स्कल्पचर्सहरू म तपाईँलाई त्यो क्वेसन सोध्छु त
हाम्रो चाहिँ जुन बजार चालेन भन्ने भन्ने कुराहरू भन्दा पनि हामीसँग त्यो स्रोत चाहिँ सजिलोसँग उपलब्ध छैन अब अङ्ग्रेजीमा चाहिँ अहिले उपलब्ध हुँदै आएको छ तर चाहिँ त्यो तालमानको कुरा चाहिँ आर्ट गर्दाखेरि जुन पेन्टिङ गर्दाखेरि विभिन्न स्रोतहरू खोज्दाखेरि पनि त्यो पेन्टिङ गर्नको लागि चाहिँ स्पष्ट रूपबाट चाहिँ छैन अनि त्यो आइकोनोग्राफीको कुरा र दर्शनको कुरा बजाचार्यबाट चाहिँ बुझ्न सकिन्छ तर चित्रकलाको लागि चाहिँ बजाचार्यबाट केही पनि केही पनि छैन आएको छैन त्यो ट्रान्सफर्म भएको पनि छैन होइन अब म चाहिँ चित्रकार फ्यामिलीमा हुर्केको हुनाले यसको केही ट्रेडिसनहरू थाहा भएको हुनाले यो परम्परागत उसमा चाहिँ लापिस लाजुरी र मालाकाई प्रयोग गर्ने छैन त्यसमा इन्डिगोबाट चाहिँ अरू रङहरू बनाउने परम्परा छ पछि जुन मैले पनि एउटा पेन्टिङ मात्रै बाहिर निकालेको छु लापिस र मालाकाई प्रयोग गरेर त्यो गर्न सकिन्छ भने देखाएको छु तर चाहिँ हाम्रो चाहिँ ट्रेडिसनमा त्यो चाहिँ छैन अनि यो मेरो अर्को प्रश्न चाहिँ जुन तालमान चाहिँ हामीले सरलसँग कसरी लिने वास्तवमा अब समरङ्ग सूत्र ढाड चित्रसूत्र त्यस्तै प्रतिमालोचन विधान इत्यादि कुराहरूमा चाहिँ दिएको छ भने त त्यो पढ्दाखेरि चाहिँ हामीलाई चित्र कोर्नुको लागि स्पष्ट रूपमा चाहिँ छैन अब एउटा स्कलरहरूको चाहिँ भुटी विलासको कुराबाट चाहिँ आइकोनोग्राफी जस्तो उसको सबै कुराहरू आउँछ तर हामी चाहिँ ठिक टु द पोइन्ट चाहिँ चित्र कोर्दाखेरि त्यो पनि छैन मेरो अर्को एउटा प्रश्न चाहिँ समुद्रको आजको त्यो कुरा र त्यति धेरै कुरा निस्किएन जस्तो लाग्छ अनि यो ट्रेडिसनल जुन तालमानको कुरा र समुद्रको अहिलेको पेन्टिङको कुरामा एस्थेटिकको मात्रै छ कि धार्मिक रिचुअलको पनि केही छ कि त्यो पनि एकचोटि उहाँको
So just very briefly to translate, iconometric drawing that one can often translate that textual description into the practice itself. So that's one of the things that he feels. And also in terms of the use of malachite and lapis, it isn't a tradition that we find in the Newar tradition, rather it's indigo. So we found that quite interesting that the use of, or the lack of use of lapis. And then two questions that he would like to present to the audience and certainly to you is,
first question.
So what would be a resource then or a solution for only having textual descriptions without the practice images itself? So that's question number one. Then question number two, leading back then to Samundra's work. Is it only about the aesthetics of the work or does it reflect the type of inner philosophy itself?
First question, as regards iconometric drawings, in, I think in Mandala Point Bookshop or Raja Bookshop, you can find a book called Tibetan Thanka Painting, Materials and Techniques by David Jackson. You can buy it for Tibetan Thanka Painting, Materials and Techniques by David and Janice Jackson, which has all about the pigments used, how the binders are made, how the canvas is prepared, how the frames are made, and all the iconographical grids in there are drawn by myself. And you can learn there from that about the different systems of measurements. It would only cost you a couple of, it would only cost you maybe, I don't know, 3,000 rupees, I have no idea. It's worth investing in that if you want to learn that. So that's the answer to that. It is available here. That is the same system of measurements. I've made all of the drawings. There's a lot of drawings in the back. I was never paid for making those drawings in the book. This is a problem with people like us. And the next question, shall I answer the next question or would you like to translate?
Newar Goa tradition, I have not seen any underlaid drawings that use the iconometrics. It seems that it's much more freehand. And proportions are of course very systematic, but without having the grid system. So I think we need to distinguish between the proportions versus the grid, it seems, or is that the case?
Once you learn to draw on a grid, you don't need to make a grid. They basically would have a piece of bamboo, Tibetan artists would have a piece of bamboo and just you'd have the units of measurements and just use it like, you know, the distance between, like the chakras, the sacral chakra here, the distance is 12 units to the navel, 12 units to the heart, 12 units to the throat, 12 units to between the eyes, and 12 units to the ushnisha, the top. But are those things you learn, you just learn? As an illustration, I also studied classical Indian music, and I learned sarod, and the first raga I learned was Yaman Kalyan. I probably spent 9 months learning this one raga. After that, I learned bhairav, and bhairav took me maybe 3 months, and after that, 1 month, 2 weeks to learn a new raga. Later on, very quick, it becomes internal. You're able to see and almost to project the image. And these people who were making those icons at that time probably had these skills. They certainly had them in the time when the Newars were working in Tibet, in the time of Abdul around that time.
So,
we
have a question
to answer
to Waki Munjani about the symmetric system, the measurement system. The foundation that त्यसको तालिम भइसकेपछि चाहिँ त्यो ग्रिड सिस्टमै चाहिँ सो एकैचोटि हेरेर नै हाम्रो पौवा आर्टिस्टहरूले त्यो गर्न सक्यो होला तर त्यो जुन चाहिँ प्रपोर्सन्स हो त्यो चाहिँ हाम्रो लागि जान्न जरुरी छ जो चाहिँ 12 औँलाको यो तल हाम्रो चक्रदेखि तल चक्रदेखि माथि उष्णिसोसम्म चाहिँ 12 युनिटको जुन छ त्यो चाहिँ गर्नु जरुरी छ सो त्यसले अब पहिला 13th-14th century art जुन भगवान् हुन्छ त्यसमा चाहिँ त्यस्तो किसिमको साधना प्राप्त practicing Hiragati. One for a brief example, so just the one is a classical Indian music, Punisikumbo. So, Euta, Paila Rag, Jusit Malisita, he no minor lag. This was Bairavi Rag, in minor. This was the only word that can say, Mutimada, Hey, come somewhere like you, Wanakuma, say, the foundation of an academic theory, but it treats you very positive and come back. Now you have to come back to the second question.
Second question about the colors. In Rajasthan, I'm talking about 60, around 60, 59, 60 different natural pigments. The main greens and blues used in Newar and Tibetan art is malachite. And when you grind malachite, you get three grades, or four grades if you do it properly. If you grind it quite closely and you have pure malachite, you get a very deep green. If you grind it more, you get a middle green. Very, very bright, and you get a light green. Malachite and azurite is the blue. It's not lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli was used in Indian miniature painting. So malachite and azurite occur together naturally, and you can separate them. Indigo is a dye. Indigo and black dye are the two main dyes used for outlining in Tibetan art. And then you have dyes made from five or six different kinds of flowers, which are mainly yellow, orange, which are not that fugitive. Pinks and purples are fugitive. And then the black is made from carbon, and then the yellows used are made from arsenic, and then vermilion is made from vermilion powder, which is basically mercuric sulfide. And all of these things have that. But what is happening in Rajasthan is they have an incredible range of colors. Colors made from coral, for example, Adriatic coral, different grades of coral pink. And especially there's a colour called Hinguda, which was made from feeding mangoes to a cow until the cow produced urine that was very, very yellow and thick and was used to illustrate, to make the halos of deities. And that colour, he's the only person who still has some of that colour. It's illegal to do that because the cows die from eating mangoes. But it's an incredible yellow color. And he's the only person who knows, who has it and knows how to use it. So there's nobody else in the world who knows these things. And he's just in Rajasthan, in Jaipur. Shami, yeah.
Well, the pigments of the Bali Mahal, Rajasthan, for example, Shami, he's a master artist. And one is if you specifically mineral pigments are possibly used by the possibly possible type of specific ores are used by like the possible wrong misting jamani so just the malachite with them deep possible you must know when light this is only azurite say them blue and there is one you lapis अनि इन्डिगो अफ कोर्स ब्ल्याक एन्ड डार्क आउटलाइनिङ गर्नलाई ब्लु र ब्ल्याक अनि त्यस्तै किसिमको ओपेमेन्ट र आर्सेनिक हामीले हरिताल भन्छौँ त्यो चाहिँ एकदम पोइजनस हो त्यो चाहिँ येलोको लागि अनि समथिङ द्याट इज भेरी इन्ट्रेस्टिङ चाहिँ ट्रान्सलेट नेपाली मैले यो सक्नु ब्रिजमा 2003 एउटा पेन्टिङमा काम गर्दाखेरि हाम्रो रत्नसम्भवको येलो बडीमा चाहिँ एकदमै ब्युटिफुल त्यो माइका कलर जस्तै देखिन्थ्यो क्या अनि जब सबै आर्ट हिस्टोरियन्सले चाहिँ ऊ त्यो टिबेटमा त माइका पेन्टिङ पनि हालेको थियो त्यो यो येलोमा चाहिँ माइका पनि मिसाएको होला भनेर किन एकदम उनीहरूले चाहिँ सबै हिसाबले एकदम डार्क पेन्टिङ डार्क मोनेस्ट्रीमा चाहिँ उज्यालो देखोस् भनेर यो माइका युज गरेको भनिन्थ्यो तर सबै अर्पिमेन्ट जुन चाहिँ हरिताल चाहिँ अक्सिडाइज भएपछि चाहिँ एउटा त्यो क्रिस्टलाइज हुँदो रहेछ सो एक्चुली त्यो चाहिँ सबै त्यो खाएको क्या त्यो पेन्टिङलाई खाएकोलाई चाहिँ यस्तो ब्युटिफुल सिन दिन्छ कि सो तपाईँहरूले यो पुरानो पेन्टिङ हरियो के अरे पहेँलो हेर्दाखेरि चाहिँ त्यसमा एकदम एउटा डायमन्ड जस्तै एउटा माइका जस्तै देखिन्छ अर्को भेरी इन्ट्रेस्टिङ उहाँले कुरा गर्नुभयो हिङ्गुला भन्ने चाहिँ एउटा रङ हुँदो रहेछ जो चाहिँ त्यो गाईलाई आँप खाएर खुवाउँदा 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 त्यो गाईको जुन मूत्र हुन्छ मूल के अरे त्यो पिसाब चाहिँ एकदम डिप येलो कलरको अनि तर त्यो खाइसकेपछि चाहिँ त्यो इलिगल अहिले त्यो तपाईँलाई चाहिँ गाईले मर्ने तर त्यो चाहिँ जुन हाम्रो राजस्थानतिर त्यो जुन प्रभामण्डलमा चाहिँ त्यो किसिमको डिप येलो चलाइन्छ भनेर सो अगेन बोथ भेजिटेबल्स अनि फ्लावर्सकोबाट रङ निकाल्ने र त्यो टेक्निक चाहिँ कहिले पनि शमी भन्ने आर्टिस्टमा चाहिँ यो राजस्थानमा छ त उहाँसँग पनि एउटा कलाबरेसन गरेर सिक्न पनि सकिन्छ कि भन्ने उहाँको एउटा विचार
phrase I like, it's keep your intelligence white hot and your grief glistening, which comes from Jalagan Rumi. Keep your intelligence white hot and your grief glistening. And that's how I try to live my life, basically. And I find this mirrored in the artist. I'm older than them, I'm a generation ahead. And what I see in them is it's so much what I have to go through where virtually everything I did was unpaid, unrecognized, and always for the Dharmas, for the Buddhism, for the Lamas, this and that, and that, and that, and that. And it goes on and on. I never got royalties for most of the work I ever did. And, you know, I've been seriously abused, and I'm stupid still, but I keep going, and I don't care, actually, because it's fine. It's not about fame, it's not about glory, it's not about money, it's not about anything to do with those things. It's really about the human heart.
Absolutely. So, slowly.
And it has been slowly. But it's been also been quick. It wasn't that long ago he was saying slowly. That was back maybe 15 years ago. Yeah. That's not so long a time. It is gaining recognition, certainly in China, for example. And, you know, there are museums in Britain which have new offices. Because of the earthquake in Nepal, the Rubin Museum this year is doing a special year on Nepal, trying to raise funds for helping the victims of the earthquake. But it is slowly, it's happening, yeah. You're gaining recognition. Your name's mentioned now. Before you were anonymous,
I didn't say anything. हामीले कसरी यसलाई प्रमोट गर्ने त खालि एउटा कमर्सियल रूपको लागि मात्रै होइन कि कसरी चाहिँ हामीले यसलाई प्रमोट गर्ने जस्तो कि कम्पनीजहरूलाई चाहिँ कसरी आर्ट एज अ इन्भेस्टमेन्टको रूपमा लिन सक्छौँ भनेर द्याट आर्टलाई आर्ट किन्यो भने चाहिँ त्यो इन्भेस्टमेन्ट हो भनेर चाहिँ त्यो कसरी चेन्ज गर्ने बिकज वेस्टमा चाहिँ आर्टको इन्ट्रेस्ट किन भन्दाखेरि एज ए मनिटरी इन्भेस्टमेन्ट अहिले सस्तोमा किनेपछि 20 वर्षमा चाहिँ हामीले त्यसको यु नो 10-fold पाउन सक्छौँ सो त्यो कसरी चेन्ज गर्ने अनि आर्टलाई कसरी सपोर्ट गर्ने भनेर तपाईँलाई अडियन्सलाई मेरो क्वेसन छ
I have collected more than 5 pieces of Samundra's paintings before. I was one of the recipients before I took for art, Newar Art. And I have started this career 40 years ago. at that time in Nepal there was only two personal art collectors, one was Nar Budas and second was I. And after my started this business, nowadays I am very happy there are many art collectors coming. They are supporting many artists. This is the good news for art and artists of Nepal. And I am also always trying my best to support Newar Art and artists. For example, nowadays, before there were only two people, now there are more than 10 art writers. That is a good news for artists. But one important thing is, artists, when they paint, they don't have time to stop. So, we art collectors like us, we have to teach them. If they have done some mistake, we have to teach them. Otherwise, that art collection will be useless. For example, in this exhibition I have seen one painting of Samundra. I am not against Samundra. But being a Buddhist and being an art collector, I feel one uneasiness. For example, downstairs there is one painting of Samundra. It is published in book number 17. And the name of this subject, the thanka, it was written emptiness. Because emptiness, what does emptiness mean? Because I may be mistaken, but if I would be mistaken, please forgive me. But as a Buddhist, I understand the meaning of emptiness means the process of impermanence. First process of impermanence, then finishing on one point is emptiness. Hello or world is not emptiness. So this is the essence of Buddhism. For example, when we learn Buddhism, everywhere we talk about Pragyaparamita is a good literature of Buddhism. The essence of Pragyaparamita is what is the emptiness. But I think, I'm not saying someone is mistaken. I mean, art promoter who has commissioned that kind of art must know the meaning of emptiness. If I am wrong, please write this one. If right, please support me.
Okay, I have to be a little close, evidently. Emptiness, sunyata. Why not? The deity has disappeared from the image. Elvis has left the building. Emptiness is an ideal image of Samundra's art. Sunyata, I would use the term. In Vajrayana Buddhism, a lot of people talk about Vajrayana Buddhism. There are two gurus. There is the inner guru and the outer guru. The outer guru is the teacher who essentially is there to reveal your true nature. And your true nature is sunyata. And the true nature of the deity in the composition that Samundra has done has been taken out and is gone into its own true nature. What is left behind is the background. The world will remain as it is, but we go, and where we go is where we belong, which is home with a capital H. This is what our destiny is. Our destiny is philosophically not on this plane. This is a plane of illusion. This is a papier-mâché world that we live in. When we die, we go back to our innate nature, and from there we plan our next trip into this papier-mâché world to learn a new lesson. This is how I now understand things. So sunyata to me is not a Buddhist concept. Sunyata to me is our innate nature. So the real guru, the inner guru, is ourselves. Once we are identical with that being as such. Dina asked me to stop at this point and to tell this story. Siju Rinpoche, Thai Siju Rinpoche, very famous Lama in the Kamakagi tradition, came to England, to Samuling, to Scotland actually once, and a friend of mine was at Samuling and she said, can you bring some of your paintings down? Because Thai Sita Rinpoche really loves art. So I brought some of my Mahasiddha paintings down, which I was working on then, which was back in the 80s. And Sita Rinpoche kind of was walking along, so I suddenly had to be like one of these stupid devotees and come up to him and say, excuse me, would you like to look at some of my paintings? Which I did. And he looked at them for a few minutes and he said, in 10 years' time, these will all be destroyed. He said, this is not right. You shouldn't keep
doing this. This is not right. So I felt really bad. You know, I thought, my God, you know, I'm trying to do illustrations of the 84 man sitters. So I just felt really sad, you know. And then the next morning, he called for me because he had a dream. And I don't know what the dream was, but he asked me to be his illustrator for his books in future. So something happened, you know. There is supernatural means of identifying what is real and what is not real. And we have to believe in what we do. We have to be true to ourselves and believe in what we do. And that's all I've tried to do throughout my life. That's all this man here is doing, trying to be true to himself, and he's succeeding very well, as are all of these great artists and people in this room. And I wish all the same for all of you, that you may blossom and become beautiful human beings who are not interested in material things, but are interested in who you really are deep inside.
I think this is a very, very important point, because the whole point of having emptiness in that title was very precise. Emptiness means it's not only loss, emptiness means about transformation, shunyata vaneko, about transformation, but it has a dual meaning. The gods are leaving the country. Tapai bacha chale bhanuncha, tapai ko adam devta haru sabai. So this is the time that it is about challenging ideas, which is, it's beautiful. I want that. I want more of that. So I'm going to wrap it up. Exactly. I want to wrap it up. And you see, I think successful paintings challenge people. It's beautiful, so thank you so much, Rajendra, and I'm glad you asked that question. Painting, that's powerful. It spoke to you. You didn't talk about Vajrapani. You talked about that particular painting. So conceptual paintings are powerful, and I think Samundra did an amazing job because of that.
I'm gonna end this session right now by telling one more story. This is a story about about 100 years before Jesus lived in Jerusalem. There was two great rabbis. One was called Rabbi Hillel, H-I-L-L-E-L. And he was renowned for being able to convey the truth very, very precisely. And one day this atheist kind of person came to him and said, "If I stand on one leg, can you tell me the ultimate truth?" And so the man stood on one leg like this, and Hillel said, "Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. This is the whole truth. All the rest is commentary."
Revolves around works that are beautiful but also provoke, and so it is pushing the boundaries. So Malay, as a curator of a new work, while Samundra Manji ko makam gardai pahila ta ekdam saral hola, it's beautiful eye candy, as Robert had talked about, bhanne mate lagya thyo, tara jati bhitra bhitra pokaldai gayo, Rajendra ji le bhane jastai eta adhyatmik ra inner essence was there for me. I know, and jhan conceptual work I feel is very, very interesting. I think it's pushing the boundaries and maybe making us feel uncomfortable. Malai pani aba yelai kasari pauwa bhanne, tara that is good, you know, because again, aba as a historian ma 13 shatabdi 14 15 shatabdi ma harek shatabdi ko maile euta style ko shaili ko hisab ma lirachu. So why is it that tradition has to be static? No, tradition is always changing. Yeah. As a
जुन समसामयिक कला टु यु नो कन्टेम्परेरी भनेको छौ 20 वर्ष पछाडि तपाईँ ट्रेडिसन हुनुहुन्छ यु आर वरिष्ठ कलाकार समुद्र मान सिंह श्रेष्ठ हुनुहुन्छ राइट सो द न्यू जेनेरेसन नयाँ युवा पिँढीलाई त तपाईँको कला त एकदम बुढा बुढाहरूले गरे जस्तो हुन्छ दे आर गोइङ टु डु समथिङ एल्स सो ट्रेडिसन इज अबाउट चेन्ज एन्ड हाउ डु वी किप द्याट चेन्ज इन द वे द्याट इट इज अबाउट लेगेसी एन्ड हेरिटेज त्यो भन्दै आज तपाईँहरू यति धैर्यसम्म बस्नु भएकोमा एकदम मलाई खुसी लागेको छ र फेरि पनि मेरो चाहिँ यस्तै अन्तर्क्रिया चाहिँ अलिकति एटमा थियो तर अलि पहिले गर्नु भनेर वेबसाइटमा हुन्छ अनि हाम्रो उसमा सो थ्याङ्क यू सो मच एन्ड आइम स्योर इफ वी हेभ मोर क्वेसन्स हाम्रो रबर्टजीसँग मैले कुरा गर्नु पाएको छ सो थ्याङ्क यू सो मच फर कमिङ